I'm Luis Limlingan, and this is Stocks to Watch. We've had two big corrections after that record-breaking ascent to 9,000. You know what that means. Time to go shopping. For stocks, that is. This week, we're looking at two manufacturers. And not just any manufacturer. We're training our sights on two companies betting on the fourth industrial revolution. Talk about robotics, artificial intelligence, self-driving cars, and you're heading right up the alley of IMI, or integrated microelectronics. IMI is actually a part of the Ayala's industrial technology arm. Well, the company may not be building its own fully automated vehicles yet, but it is one of the world's leading manufacturing solutions experts. It provides electronics manufacturing services and power semiconductor assembly and test services, or SATs. IMI also participates in autonomous driving studies, and they produce key components required by digitized and electric cars. With this, we can say that IMI is preparing for the future. Right now, the company is boasting that it's the world's sixth largest automotive EMS provider. While most studies indicate that there could be a decline in car sales growth, this will not really affect IMI. After all, manufacturers are still making cars despite the slowdown, and most of them have commitments to produce required numbers of units, either for tax purposes or agreements with the government. But the future can be expensive, and IMI would need bigger coffers. It recently announced it's embarking on a stock rights offering, or SRO. As many as 350 million shares are in the offing. If you happen to have a few of its shares, then you're entitled for one stock rights share for every 3.5531 shares you hold. Now, let's look at this diagram to further illustrate the point. IMI is offering up to 350 million shares, and hopefully they plan to raise around 5 billion pesos. Now, this translates to around 15 pesos per share. But what if you don't have IMI stocks yet? Should you wait for the stock rights offer to be completed before getting in? Let's see. We have computed that if fully availed, this will have a dilutive effect of around 5% compared to the last price before the SRO was announced. This may pull its stock price down to about 18 pesos, and that could be a good price point for investors to come in. Although the stock price jumped after more details were revealed on Thursday. So, good luck if you can get it at a good price. Naturally, its sister company, BPI, will be the sole issue manager. The company says that the proceeds from the transaction will be used for business expansion and debt refinancing. Maybe self-driving cars are too far ahead, but motorcycles are not as complex. And so IMI signed a deal with Austrian brand KTM to locally manufacture its motorcycles. Since June of 2017, IMI has been producing KTM motorcycles in its complex in Laguna. Initially, the company is targeting to produce around 20,000 bikes a year, and this is for the domestic market. And it's setting its sights further in the horizon. The Ayala unit is planning to export the European brand to China and its ASEAN neighbors. IMI has also acquired Germany's VIA Optronics and UK's STI Enterprises to expand their footprint in the automotive parts segment. VIA Optronics is a leading optical bonding and display solutions provider with facilities in Germany and China. The acquisition allows IMI to provide automotive camera and display monitor solutions for advanced driver assistance systems. STI Inc., meanwhile, is a provider of electronic design and manufacturing solutions for both printed circuit board assembly and full box build manufacturing for high reliability industries. The private company currently has factories in the UK as well as in Cebu. In the first 9 months of 2017, the new ventures already contributed about 17% to the company's total revenues, and it's more than 5% to the bottom line. But have these investments paid off? For the whole year of 2017, IMI raked in over $1 billion in revenue. That is a 29% improvement compared to 2016. Last year, profits also improved to 21%, and this was around $34 million. In terms of segment, its businesses in Asia brought in almost half of its revenues. Operations in China recovered and was able to increase its revenue by the end of 2017. That's despite IMI's shift to automotive parts. A significant portion of its assets in the Middle Kingdom had to be converted to adjust to the new business models. Overall, the full year's financial results are in line with mine. What's more, revenues exceeded expectations and bottom line stayed within the range. Of course, I have high expectations for the tech firm this year with all these developments and investments. So, what should we do with IMI? First, let's recap. It's a world-class company serving the global market. Next, it's launching an SRO to fund expansion, which I think is a good buy. Next, its 2017 financial performance met or exceeded expectations. However, as a last point, its stocks, however, are rather expensive. If last year was a buy, this time I'm changing that and I'm giving IMI a hold. But take note, the market is experiencing some sort of consolidation. If IMI shares fall closer to 90 pesos, then I would start buying. Some Filipinos may not be aware that the Philippines doesn't just specialize in services. We do have a very vibrant and thriving manufacturing industry. So, let's check in on another company called Certec, which has the catchy ticker TECH. Certec provides solutions related to the manufacturing, assembly, and testing of semiconductor devices, and it's been making some big moves as of late. The company recently sold its dollar-denominated preferred shares, which garnered around $67 million in proceeds. Most of that amount will be used for the payment of its acquisition of US-based antenna firm Quintel, and the rest will be used for general working capital purposes. Why is this acquisition important? Well, Quintel designs and develops antenna solutions for mobile operators. It's a leading innovator of spectrum and space-efficient base station antennas. I think it's safe to say that our telecom industry really needs this kind of technology. In terms of capital expenditure, TECH is looking to spend around $6 to $8 million this year versus the previous estimates of around $5 to $6 million. And you can see here, that would be almost a 25% increase from last year. Most of that will go to the expansion of its facilities and increasing orders from Quintel. Recall that management said they expect to reach around $100 million in revenue upon the entry of Quintel. Bottom line, however, is only expected to be slightly better than last year. They also said that they could reach $500 million in revenue within a span of 5 years. In fact, management said that they intend to break even by the first quarter of 2018 with Quintel. But I think that would be challenging because of research costs, which are dragging down the company's margins. These research costs are related to mostly product development within Quintel, which is normal if you're a technical manufacturing firm. The prospects of the industry as a whole look promising. And I'm not just talking about tech and IMI. There's a lot of development to look forward to in that space. Quintel isn't the only new company in Certec's portfolio. TECH also acquired MultiPay Inc., which is known for providing back-end, front-end, and end-to-end systems, payment platforms, and e-commerce system integrations to over 30,000 payment channels worldwide. The company is the exclusive technological partner of payment systems like Bayad Center, which has 12,000 outlets, EasyPay, which has 10,000 outlets, and bank-based system DragonPay. Certec expects around 500 million pesos in revenues from MultiPay for 2018.
This is a move by Certec to provide an integrated commerce solution in the country because we noticed that a lot of e-payments systems in the country are fragmented, and this is preventing from the full flourishing of the e-commerce business in the country. So MultiPay is positioning itself as a e-commerce software integrator system that will connect different e-wallet, e-payment system in the country. Therefore, it can underpin faster development of the e-commerce business in the country.
Here's a snapshot of what Certec's books look like right now. As of its third quarter of 2017, net sales of the company grew by 19.2% to $25.7 million. And this led to the total 9 months 2017 performance of $67.9 million, which is an increase of 25.6%. This, however, is not reflected in their bottom line, as third quarter earnings declined by 45.5% to $1.16 million. The decline is attributable to the higher OPEX due to increased salaries, commissions, professional fees, and research costs. The 9 month 2017 bottom line declined by 1.37%, which is almost flattish. That means the strong performance of the first half was able to augment the weak third quarter performance. Although expenses were more than what I expected, the company was able to generate revenues that were within our estimated range. Remember, this was $67.9 million versus our estimate of $71 million. Still, we expect 2018 to have fewer costs as the company's investments on these firms are now near completion, and these firms should be accretive by then. I'm taking into consideration management's assertion that their bottom line guidance will be slightly better compared to the previous year. Here's a roundup of where tech stands. Sirtech has done multiple acquisitions of related firms. It has engaged in aggressive fundraising, and as of the 9 months of 2017, its performance was in line with expectations. Now, this is thanks to a strong first half, which offset the weaker third quarter. The stock price has practically doubled from last year, so the price is trading at a premium right now. Hence, I'd have to keep this company at a hold. Again, the market is in the consolidation. So if the stock prices drop between 5 to 10%, then I wouldn't mind snapping up some shares. That's two hold recommendations in a similar space. But it doesn't mean there's no growth in the industry. In this case, both stocks just shot up too quickly, in my opinion. I hope you found this segment worth sharing on social media. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter on Bloomberg TV Philippines. I'm Luis Limlingan, and this is Stocks to Watch.